something such as a book, a person, a sentence, a recipe that you thought it was interested, but interesting, but didn't pay much attention at that time, and later on really needed and couldn't remember the name? Well, this is what happened to me with Toastmaster, as you are going to hear in the story I'm going to tell you now. So I was born in Madrid. I have lived here for all my life, except for 4 years that I lived in the States, in Baltimore, a city half an hour away from Washington, D.C. Before moving to the States, I finished my degree in chemistry, and I started a PhD program at the Complutense University in related with the cancer field. At the end of the four-year program, I have to defend my thesis, and it's then when I realized I really have a huge lack of oral communication skills. As an example, this is what my supervisor said. I have never heard, during the rehearsals, she said, I have never heard a person using the exactly same words one rehearsal after another. Yes, I have to learn my talk by heart, because I was panicking. I was going blank during the defense. Anyway, I was able to successfully defend my thesis, but I remember that previous months rehearsing as one of the most stressful times in my life. So after I got my PhD, I moved to the States to start my postdoctoral training. I recall those years in the States as one of the best times in my life, both personally and professionally. And it was there when I heard for the first time about Toastmaster. It was from an American friend that was working for NSA, the National Security Agency. And he was attending to these meetings. I was surprised because he was such a good speaker. I became interested, but I was so busy at that time that I didn't even try. But I kept it in my mind, at least is what I thought. So when I finished my stay in the States, I came back to Spain and joined the Spanish National Cancer Research Center to continue with my research. And I've been working there since then. Besides research, I have always liked management. That's why I 2 years after arriving to Spain, I took an MBA Light program in public health management. And over there, I have to give speeches every other day. And it's when I determined I really have to do something about my oratory skills, because I felt so bad in front of my colleagues that they were all from the marketing and sales field. It was then when I recall this club my American friend was attending, but damn it, I couldn't remember the name of this club. I searched very hardly in the internet in many different ways, and it was impossible. It has to pass several years until Ana Botella pronounced her famous relaxing café con leche to hear again about Toastmaster. It was the next day in an article published in El País newspaper that they were talking about the lack of communication skills that Spaniards have in general. And they proposed several ways to improve this aspect, and one of them was Toastmaster. As soon as I read the word Toastmaster, I knew it was the word I was missing. So since that time, it took me a while to join Toastmaster, because I had a huge peak of work finishing up a research article. But here I am, giving my first my icebreaker 10 years after I heard for the first time about Toastmaster. that's as they say in English, better late than never. Thank you very much.